Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Now, I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily targeted for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, does it hurt to inject insulin every day? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Now, this is a great question, and anyone who tells you that it doesn't hurt, well, I wouldn't put too much stock in anything else they say. That being said, it is not the same hurt as other injections. You do actually get used to it, but it still hurts. It doesn't really bother you as much. You feel it, but it's not something that, you know, you yell ouch to, but the good news is, it's getting less painful with technology. You see, there are different ways to take insulin, including syringes, insulin pins, insulin pumps, and jet injectors. Now, your doctor will help you decide which technique is best for you. Syringes remain a common method of insulin delivery. They're at least the least expensive, at least, and most insurance companies cover them. Now, for those of you with pre-diabetes, you probably don't need to worry about this right now, and I hope you never do. Now, syringes vary by the amount of insulin they hold and the size of the needle. They're made of plastic, and they need to be discarded after one use. Traditionally, needles used in insulin therapy were 12.7 millimeters in length. Research recently shows that smaller ones like 8, 6, and even 4 millimeter needles are just as effective, regardless of body mass. So this means insulin injection is less painful than it was in the past. Rather, as a matter of fact, the needles are about a third the size that they used to be. Now, I personally use an insulin pin, which is a very small needle, because I also have Parkinson's disease, and drawing insulin into a syringe, well, let's just say if you had a video camera, you might win some money videoing me try to do that. Now, the next question generally is where to inject insulin. Now, insulin is injected subcutaneously. That means it's injected into the fat layer under the skin. In this type of injection, a short needle is used to inject insulin into the fatty layer between the skin and the muscle. Insulin should be injected into the fatty tissue just below your skin. If you inject the insulin deeper into your muscle, your body will absorb it too quickly. It might not last as long, and the injection is usually more painful. It could also lead to low blood glucose levels. People who take insulin daily should rotate their injection sites. This is important because using the same spot over time can cause lipodystrophy. In this condition, fat either breaks down or builds up under the skin, causing lumps or indentations that interfere with insulin absorption. You can rotate to different areas of your abdomen, keeping injection sites about an inch apart, or you can inject insulin into other parts of your body, including your thigh, arms, and buttocks, in the words of Forrest Gump. The preferred site for insulin injection is your abdomen. Insulin is absorbed more quickly and predictably there, and this part of your body is also easy for you to reach. Select a site between the bottom of your ribs and your pubic area, steering clear of about a 2-inch area surrounding your navel. That is the most preferred method. Now, I personally have used my thighs before, and it tends to hurt more in the thigh area. I've never tried to reach around and put an injection into my buttocks. Does it hurt? Heck yes, it hurts, but it's not the same hurt. But the benefits far outweigh any discomfort, I promise. Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.